Hello, friends and fellow adventurers. Welcome to the Min-Maxed Podcast. We want to thank you for joining us, and you do so as we continue Bloodlords. As always, we'd like to invite you to come join our Discord, where you can hang out with us and other listeners of the show. And if you'd like to throw a little financial support our way, you can check out our Patreon, and a shout-out to all of those that are Lich level and above. Rock Jedi, Wolf, Barnabas Slump, Thunder Mammoth, The Trevor Project, Das Chris, Fizgig, AC Goldner, Arab Carr, Opta's Gonna Secret Pasture There, Indie Link, Tawdry Monster, Mercutio, Angel Shadow Art, Cyrendon, The Necromancer Forever, Doc Holiday, Corey, Jason K, Dicky Lopez, Bobson Dugnut, Ricky Ropebridge, Alex K, Doma Elaka, Frank L, Just Mike Works, Rusty, Argoon's Long Lost Elbow, Fig Tear, Zach S, Jimmy H, Mr. Turtle, Sleeve, Darren, Caleb W, Pickle, Mr. Grim, Fire Down, M54, Ewaz, Jameson S, Eric R, Plus 2 Vorpal Zaman of Whacking, I'm Not a Robot, George F, Leohard, Hard, Witch Hunter, Jeremy D, Matthew M, Scotty E, Progeny of Kuchu Lane, Liz Giggles, Calistria Specialty, Brandon K, and Gringus Maximus. Shout out to new patron this week at the Lich level, Andrew G. Thank you all so much for your support. And now a recap of session 23. Still in the rain-soaked Axon Wood, searching for the cabin of a hag named Iron Tavia, we come across a temple with some ghosts. They're annoying, and even though Gerdra goes down, it never feels like we're really in trouble as Arius cuts through them. We heal up, explore the temple, and find some interesting loot. We continue on and shortly find what we believe to be Iron Tavia's hut. We approach two fetchling groundskeepers. They try to persuade us to go inside. We kill them instead. As we start to plan how we want to enter the cottage, Kick suggests we just set it on fire. Seems like a good idea. We get ourselves set up to do exactly that.
All right. Sundrinker begins to maneuver the carpet into the fire, and Kix is tossing things in, you know, burning items in through the window. Was it Lucan is lighting the bushes on fire outside?
Yep, that's where I'm at.
Okay, all right. I just want to make sure that's where we're going to take off. So here's what we're going to do. I'm going to have all four of you roll for your initiatives at the start of this. You're using perception, not stealth. This is going to be a little tedious to start off with, but we're going to try to keep it as narrative as we possibly can, because a lot of this is going to be, you know, I'm continuing to try to burn the cottage down, and a lot of the cottage's residents trying to, well, stop you from burning the cottage down. And everybody is going to have, you know, turn orders inside of the cottage. So, go ahead and give me those perception checks.
I wish to intimidate the house. Roll intimidation.
You'll have to wait for part two.
Let's get the house. What am I perceiving?
You're not perceiving anything. You're in rolling initiative.
Oh, initiative. This is where I'll do good. I'm just fucking... Just kidding.
How careful would you say you were being about this?
Oh, it's pretty reckless, I would think.
Yeah,
it's kind of agreeing.
I don't think there's a lot of, like...
Yeah.
There's fire in our eyes, and we're just like... Bah!
Not a whole lot of thought going into this.
Call me Taylor Momsen, because this is pretty reckless.
I mean, that's actually pretty good, David. I'll take that. Oh, good job. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it was like, Kick said, hey, we should start on fire, and it was like, okay.
That you had a thought of maybe, like, what would Berline object to this? And then her response is, I think murder is best for everyone involved.
Fastest way to kill everybody is, you know, lock them into a building and burn it down.
Burn it to the ground. Here we are, top of round one, outside of Iron Tavia's cottage. Taking actions to burn this fucker to the ground. Lucan, you're at the top of round one. How are you burning this motherfucker to the ground? We'll say that everyone did their pre-combat bits, which would include Gerdrug unlocking the window and opening it, Sundrinker preparing to move the carpet, Kix preparing to throw on-fire items in through the window, Arius watching, and Lucan preparing to burn bushes.
Arius is a little creep.
Yeah.
Just creeping on his... Oh, yeah. It's just a... Well, firebug, huh?
Is Lucan able to burn bushes? Is that against your...
That's what's gonna find. That's what we're gonna find out. I've got a torch lit, and I'm gonna try and start lighting the closest bushes to the house on fire.
I meant like mentally,
is it against
personally,
your
because of your...
Sundrinker react to you lighting a bush on fire while like making eye contact with Sundrinker?
Honestly, fine.
And your deceased druid husband.
Yeah, you know. It's
They never saw that closely, eye to eye, you know? Like.
It's complicated, but at least for right now, lighting plants on fire is all good. It's fine. It's fine.
I mean, you're not a fucking druid. Who cares?
Yeah, I'm not a druid. It's all in service of burning a witch, so you know.
He would understand.
Honestly, that's the worst thing. Like, I kind of like witches.
So what you're saying is the standard motto, the ends justify the means.
The ends justify the means, yes. Yes. So yeah, Lucan will take an action to attempt to light a bush on fire.
And what do you use to do so?
I have a torch. I'll say I've made a torch.
Okay. So as you hold the torch against the bush, it's going to be all three of your actions. It begins to burn. It crackles because there's been that light sprinkle that's been happening all around you since you've entered the forest, that overcast sky. So things are damp. The leaves take a little bit, but they do begin to slowly light.
And you're saying that's all three of my actions?
Unless there's a way that you can amplify that.
Can I act together for two of them so Sundricker can try and throw the carpet?
Yes, I'll allow that.
Okay, I'll do that. And so then, yes, then Sundricker will reach the window and try and throw the carpet into the fire. What do you want, like an athletics check?
For that, I don't actually need any check because Sundricker is a beefy rose bush. You're moving a carpet.
With reach.
Yeah, with reach. So no check
Sweet.
Needed.
I do that.
What
I throw the carpet into the fire.
Sundrinker's reach is 10 feet?
Well, Sundrinker's reach is 5 feet, but he has the ability to attack at 10 feet.
Okay.
So he doesn't actually have a 10-foot reach, which is something I know we fucked up in the past that I forgot. Because, like, I think at least one time Swanee got flanking with me and I was 10 feet away, and that shouldn't have actually happened.
How about this? Make an athletics check to shove, which has the attack trait, which will justify the 10-foot reach, and you're shoving the carpet into the fire.
That makes sense to me. I get a 29.
29 is a critical success, because level-based DC is 19. So
love that.
You push it all the way into the fire, and Sundrinker needs to give me a perception check.
All right, perception check. The goal was to only get, like, a bit of it in the fire, so that the rest of it could burn and start other things in the room on fire, if possible. 15 perception check.
It doesn't take much more than that to see that after the carpet reaches the edge of the fireplace animates, grabs the edge of the carpet, and starts eating the carpet. And it's... And you can see, like, the bottom of the iron holster for the wood, I can't remember what that's called, the iron grating at the bottom of the fireplace, almost as a bottom jaw, and the top of the stone sharpening as it goes down to bring the fireplace, or the carpet, into it.
The fireplace is a fucking mimic?
Just end the fireplace.
Let me show you a picture of the fireplace.
Motherfucker. Alright, new plan. Get some epicac. Throw it down the chimney and let the fireplace do the work. That's how this is going to happen.
That is Lucan's turn. That takes us to Arius.
And also that picture is definitely of a mimic disguised as a fireplace. That is 100% what that is.
Arius looks at the fire, nods appreciatingly, and passes his turn.
Gerdrug, it's your turn.
Praise be to Zeriel. one of her domains is fire, so it's acceptable.
Is it?
I totally, you know, took a step back, and I'm going to literally watch the world burn.
Beautiful. The animated fireplace is going to eat a carpet.
Gets mad that there's nothing else to do.
It just starts eating the carpet, and Kix and Sundrinker can see through the window that the curtains around the window are starting to catch a blaze. The baseboards are starting to catch fire as well.
Would you say it's munching some rug?
Oh, it's absolutely rug munching right now. Kix, it's your turn.
Yeah, I just use telekinetic projectile to start whipping stuff around. Just helping the fire a turn at a time.
Picking up something that's on fire and tossing it over to the other side of the room.
Yeah, just spreading this shit.
All right. After kicks, takes us to one of the cottage's occupants. We find ourselves cutting over to a kitchen with a pantry. And in the kitchen and pantry are two fetchlings. One man, one woman, standing in the kitchen, eating snacks, some dried beef or flatbread. The man looks at the woman and says,
Anatala, did you hear that?
What are you talking about, Gessmon? It's like 1 a.m. I'd like to eat my beef stick and go back to bed.
Right. No, sure. I hear you. But did you hear that?
He uses his first action to point out. Oh, I did. What was that?
He uses his second action to come up through the kitchen into the common room to see the fireplace eating the carpet and a rose bush and a tiefling outside the front porch window throwing in burning items.
Hey, somebody's trying to burn the cottage down! And Tala, get in here!
What the fuck is... What do you mean?
For his third action, he goes up to the carpet to try to pull the carpet away from the, well, the animated fireplace. That's the end of his action. The other fetchling that's here uses her first action to grab her dagger. Second action to go into the room.
Is she gonna go fight a fireplace with a dagger?
And use her third action to seek. And with her seek action, she looks out the window and sees Sundrinker and kicks. Which takes us to the top of round two. Lucan, it's your turn.
All right, well, I don't want to be standing in front of this window about to get dumped on. So action one will move in tandem. Sundrinker will kind of move to the other side of the door. And then Lucan... we'll move over to the porch as well. Not on the porch, but below the porch, ready to fight anything that might come out. Yeah, that's where I'll move to. I have two actions left. I should cast a spell. Yes, I cast Thundering Dominance on Sundrinker. This is the thing that lets me make intimidation checks better, and also I can, as a reaction, end it to blow up.
Ah, the Thundering Dominance, or Thundering Roar action that you used in the brewery. Got it. Okay.
Yes, that's what I do. All right, that's my turn.
All right. After Lucan, Arius, it's your turn.
Do I know there's new enemies, or am I still just chilling here?
Give me a perception check.
Not good. 12.
You don't know anybody's there.
I continue to admire the fire.
All right. Gerdrug, it's your turn.
It's a perception check to find out if there's anybody to notice.
Yes.
I'm sorry, I probably should have called that out, but I didn't.
24.
24, you do hear the tail end of the conversation between the two fetchlings that were inside the cottage.
Wait, Lucan, you're telling me that the gardeners, like, lied to us about there being more people?
Yes, how strange. I guess more that we'll have to kill.
A bunch of little bitches.
Obviously. They work for a witch.
The witch's bitches?
They're the witch's bitches.
Yeah. Gerdrug goes up to the door. Is it locked?
The door is not locked.
That was one action. Second two actions to ready action to attack anywhere that opens the door.
Okay. Then after Gerdrug, it's the animated fireplace's turn, and they use all three actions to try to eat the carpet. First is an athletics check versus the fetchling's fortitude DC. It gets a 25, which is a success. So it pulls some of the carpet away from the fetchling who's fighting it and eats a little bit more of it. With its second action, it does it again. This time gets a 22, which is also a success, and continues to eat more carpet. And with its third action, he thinks about it, and then he eats more carpet. Or tries
this
to.
This guy.
He gets a 10.
Girl's best friend.
And he doesn't quite... It's getting to, like, the last, like, 5 feet of this 15-foot-long carpet that is just being devoured by this animated fireplace. The floorboards are on fire. The curtains are on fire around it. And this fetchling is just trying his damnedest to hang on and keeps getting drunk closer to the fireplace. And that's the fireplace's turn. Kix, it's your turn.
I inform the party that it looks like we've got the attention of two more fetchlings as I toss something smoldering at the dagger-wielding person's foot. It's not an attack. I'm just tossing it there. I'm just spreading more shit menacingly.
An on-fire stick ends up into the, like, right at her feet at the floorboards, and she looks up at you and she snarls.
But with that, I will probably leave the window.
Use your last action to get the fuck out of there.
Well, no, yeah, just to back up a little bit. We'll give room for Arius. I'll tell him that there's two ugly-ass fetchlings in there. Not to be confused with beautiful tieflings.
The first fetchling, the one that's got his grip on the carpet, realizes that that is just not worth his time. He uses a free action to release the carpet and then grabs his cloak with a second action, and then with a third action begins to tamp out the fire on the floor. And since I don't really have clear rules on how to do this, what I'm going to do is have him roll a flat DC 11 check, and if he succeeds, he puts out the 5-foot square that he's moving to put out, which means I need to actively mark squares that are on fire.
I mean, you need a 15 to put out persistent damage.
The house is persistent fire damage.
I hear that. No, okay, I hear that. That makes actually a lot of sense.
You get an advantage if you have a extinguisher.
Which he doesn't.
Oh.
Okay, yeah, so I like the DC 15, because you're right, that's persistent. If they introduce water, it'll be a different story. But for right now, he fails to put out the square that he's aiming for with his cloak. Which takes us over to the fetchling who grabbed her dagger. She looks at the smoldering branch that's at her feet that kicks through in at her. And she snarls again. Looks at the now empty window. Spent her first action to stride up to the door. Second action to lock the door.
Brilliant.
And with her third action, assist her partner in trying to put out the flames, which she will do with a... with her third action, she has to take off her cloak, and then she'll start doing that next round. She doesn't have any other good way to do it.
Just a side note, we still have the sides, like, happening. Like, the sides of the house. At least starting.
Yeah, like, the outsides, are they starting to start on fire at all?
No.
Just the inside?
Just the floorboards inside.
Like, it looks like it failed to start, or it's, like, still just happening?
It's slowly happening. Because of how wet the vegetation is outside, it's taking much longer to start.
Well, and it's like finished wood. Like, it's kind of, it takes a minute.
Yeah, exactly. But even the bushes are taking a minute to light, too. So top of round three, Lucan, it's your turn.
Okay. Don't see anything to attack yet, huh?
Nope.
Guess I don't really have anything to do.
Did I hear her lock the door?
Give me a perception check.
20.
Yes. Yes, you did.
Locking themselves in a burning building. Really smart.
Well, she locked the door. I'm guessing they're trying to put the fire out.
I think I'm, like, going to take all three actions with Sun Drinker. Sun Drinker's going to try and, like, rip a bush. Like that bush out of the ground next to them.
I see what you're circling there with your little pointer. Okay.
Yeah, do you want like an athletics check to do that?
Yeah, I'll take an athletics check to do that.
All right.
I would say it'd be an easy check for Sundrinker.
I get a 26.
Which is a success. That's a critical success. So yes, you are able to do so.
The bush grabs a bush.
Yes.
Now the Sundrinker will try to climb on top of the building. Here's another athletics check.
Shove it down the chimney.
Yeah, smoke them out. I get a 15.
15 is a regular success.
I move 5 feet up. No, it's 5 feet plus 5 feet for every 20 feet of movement. So I move 10 feet up.
You'd be able to get to the edge of the eaves with that.
Then with my third action, I'll pull myself on top.
Okay. The Sun Drinker's on top of the roof. Arius, it's your turn.
So we still haven't had any enemies come out. They just locked the door. Sun Drinker's pulled a bush and is climbing.
Correct.
I will be attempting to unlock the door once it's my turn.
But it's perfect. They just let themselves in there.
Yeah, but I mean, if they put the fire out, then...
I'll delay as I'm, or hold as I'm trying to figure out, like, what I should be doing.
There's still the fire outside.
That's not really going very far.
It'll go. It still needs attention eventually.
Alright, then after Arius delays, that takes us to Gerdrug.
I try to pick the lock.
Two actions, give me a thievery check.
27.
That is a success. One success. You need more.
A critical success on a 27? Holy crap.
It's not. But yes, that is one success. You have one more action? Not sure what you're going to do with that, though.
Yeah, I've got one action. I'm not going to do
anything. Okay. Then that takes us to the animated fireplace, who doesn't need to make checks this time to keep eating the rug. He just gets to keep eating the rug. So he's going to do that. Takes him two actions to finish bringing the rug into his maw, and just this black sooty smoke bellows out from the front of it, and even from outside you can see the chimney is spewing dark black smoke. And that's the fireplace's turn. Kix, it's your turn.
Where did Lucan start the fire? Over here on the right side?
He's shooting for over here. This is the bush that I'm aiming for. It's barely on fire. The bush is not doing great from a fire standpoint.
I will assist whatever you want for that.
Light a torch and hold it under there.
Well, I'd more so like just giving it air. I feel like would probably be more than lighting more
fire.
Kix
just goes up to it and starts blowing on it. He's like fanning the fire.
That's gonna be better than adding more flame.
That is what you do to fighters to get them stuck going.
Yeah, you're not wrong. All right, we'll start the fire stage up a little further. Since how many actions did you spend on that?
Probably two.
Two. Okay, so
outside of my movement.
We'll cross a little bit of a threshold here and say that bush on the edge here on the east side of the building is now on fire proper. Which takes us over to one of the fetchlings inside. They are going to continue attempting to put out the fire. He gets an 18 on the d20. He succeeds at putting out this square right next to the fireplace, which is one of six squares. So there are five squares that are still on fire.
On what turn is the fire spreading?
On the animated fireplace's turn. It was four squares last round. Now it's six.
Okay.
Which then takes us over to the other fetchling who had previously doffed her cloak and is going to also attempt to put out a square. Fails with a six on the die. There are still five squares burning inside. Top of round four, Lucan, it's your turn.
All right, well, Sundrinker will go over to that chimney and just ram that bush down in there, trying to block it so all the smoke goes back down into the building.
This is so fucked up and I love it.
because I want to check for it, give me an athletics check to get that bush real deep in that chimney.
All right. How about a nat 20?
Yeah, that'll do it.
Bushes, no bushes, man.
That'll get it all the way in.
That'll get it all the way in. That is nuts.
I feel like having him push down his brother.
It is completely nonsense.
Totally going.
It's not completely at all, but still.
That is not just the tip.
And then Sundrinker will jump back down onto the porch next to Gerdrug.
The black smoke stops billowing out the top of the chimney as Sundrinker gets it all the way in. That takes us over to Arius. It's your turn.
You continue to delay or hold, waiting for an opportunity to do something.
Waiting.
I don't know what else to do. I guess I could go pull a bush up and, like... No, I got nothing.
I just picture Arius just outside, greatsword in both hands, waiting.
I mean, you'd probably be, like, upset, right? Isn't your whole thing, like the fact that, like, this... Like, or do you not care about, like, like loyal combat or anything. I guess I don't know what your god does.
Oh, like honorable combat?
Yeah, I guess that's what
I don't give a fuck about honorable combat. Oh, okay. No.
That's, I guess that's all. Okay. No. Never mind.
That's not a thing. I prefer people die in warfare and aren't just like...
We'll get there.
You could consider this a raid.
A raid, yes.
Absolutely.
I mean, would you like me to do like a lore warfare to see if this is acceptable as warfare?
Yeah. Yes, please. Roll d20s, Ted.
Okay.
DC standard for this level is 19.
Is this acceptable warfare with a 23?
You have a moment where you flash back to leading a troop of unknown soldiers against an enemy watchtower and raising it to the ground. And as that memory occurs to you, yeah, this is what warfare is like.
I just get like a little smirk, like, okay. Yeah.
Fire!
Then as Arius smiles in glee at the fire, Gerdrug, it's your turn.
Oh, now I'm conflicted because, you know, they're going to have to come out of the house now. If the smoke's really that bad in there, they're going to try to come out. And now I want to relock the door. Can I jam the lock now? I want to jam the lock.
You want to jam it? So this is a disabled device as opposed to a pick a lock.
I mean, it's the same check and I think the same action, so...
Gerdrug's just confused. He's like, oh, fuck.
It is the same check, same number of actions, so yeah.
22.
A 22 is a failure.
To jam a lock? How hard is it to just shove something in the lock?
I was just using the thievery DC to unlock it, which is 25. Considering you've already successfully partially unlocked it, I'm going to say, yeah, that's a failure.
Well, that's two of my actions, so... Okay, we're going to step back from the door. Let him burn.
All right. That takes us over to the animated fireplace inside, who has now finished devouring the carpet and is now billowing black smoke into the common room. And you all, even outside, see it start to billow out of the window you had breached earlier. The fireplace uses an action called Bellow Soot.
What a silly sentence.
Yeah.
The fireplace uses an action.
It's true. It's true. No context, Pathfinder 2nd edition. The two fetchlings inside need to make fortitude saves.
Bellow Soot. That poor fireplace. It's like I'm choking him.
Okay, so we've got a failure and a success. The tiefling man, who was the first one that was trying to pull the carpet back from the fireplace, is coughing deeply, having been so close to it, and this first gout of soot coming at him really hits him in the face, and he starts coughing and coughing. He is sickened one. And then the other one with a success is fine. Kix. How about the fireplace is choking out the fetchlings inside? It's your turn.
Any windows on my side now? I can't remember what you... Don't remember.
No, on that side of the building, the east side, there are really no other windows.
Alright, well, I just keep... just actions upon actions of assisting a fire.
So you're fanning
burn,
the flames?
Burn, baby, burn!
Fanning, adding more, like, bushes around here.
Okay. So go ahead and roll a d20. DC 11 to further fan the flames.
Eight. I did do it. Is that all? Will that be all three, or would it be continued as D20?
That would just be your turn.
Okay.
You do not make it worse, but the bushes that are on fire outside are not catching the walls on fire. That takes us inside with the fetchlings. The first one uses an action to attempt to clear the sickened condition with a fortitude save. Succeeds with a 21. Uses their second and third actions to attempt to continue to put out the flames. That time they get a 15, they successfully put out one flame. And the other fetchling does the same thing, gets an 11, and succeeds at putting out another square.
No!
Gerdrug and Sundrinker, give me perception checks.
No good for me.
Gerdrug?
Another 9, 17.
Nah.
So it's like a 9s.
it doesn't seem as though the fire is spreading much more. In fact, the smoke that was coming out of the windows seems to be lessening some.
Wouldn't it be getting worse?
But it's not.
Put out fires?
Lucan, it's your turn.
Fuck magic, Tyler.
It's not even magic. It's just, you know, it's rainy outside, and you're starting bushes on fire outside.
I'm just arguing there's still a fire pit inside that's covered up.
Oh, it's yeah, that whole thing.
Getting
but
continuously
there's still a
worse.
Giant fire inside that would be spreading faster than they should be able to put it out.
Action one.
Unless there are things that are occurring that you're not aware of.
I'm aware of everything.
I don't think that's the case.
Omnipotent.
Omnipotent.
So Lucan, it's your turn. Top around five.
Sundrinker goes over to the window, sees a person there. With action one, goes to the window.
You see, yes? As you look in the window, a small, ever so tiny, very old-looking man.
Oh.
Standing on the table just outside the fire, casting spells at the flames, torrents of water are coming out as it is putting out the flames from inside.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, use more spell slots.
Well, that explains that. Anyway, action two. Sundrinker attacks this person who's on the other side of the window. Through the window? Why not?
That would be the one who was sickened, but cleared it, and was successfully putting out fire.
And we'll go slashing on this if I hit. Attack! I get a 27.
Even with the greater cover that you have, that is a hit.
I will deal 19 damage slashing, and with action 3, I walk over to the other side of the door.
And as Sundrinker reaches in and slices this fetchling across the chest. As they're trying to put out the fire, it's right over her collarbone and her neck. She starts bleeding heavily onto the floor. She's not down, but she's frantically trying to put the fire out.
It's my turn.
Arius, it's your turn.
Guys, what should I be doing?
I think at this point, whatever you want.
Oh, by the way,
Sundrinker says as a free action,
there's a little magic man in there putting the fires out with magic water.
But he's inside the burning building?
Yes.
You're a skeleton. What's fire damage gonna do to you?
Kill me?
That's not how things work.
Bones burn. Have you ever heard of cremation?
I'm just gonna go stand in front of the door.
How hot does it need? I wanted to Google it.
It has to get really hot.
I was gonna Google it, but I don't feel like that's the thing I should be Googling. The temperature bones burn.
Just Google how hot does a cremation oven get.
Make sure you put the human before bones.
Human bones!
Just be like, how do I cremate a body myself?
1800 degrees Fahrenheit.
If I were to cremate a body, how hot would the fire need to be?
I'll chill in front of the door, just wait for people, for somebody to open it.
Then after Arius, that takes us over to Gerdrug. It's your turn.
Ugh, these guys are annoying me.
We're the ones setting the house on fire.
I'm going to try something I haven't done yet. First action, I'm going to draw out my striking returning dagger. Second action, move over to the window. Third action, throw it at this dude.
Which dude? You see two...
Match me!
Two fetchlings inside.
The one that looks really injured.
Okay, that's the one that Sundrinker hit. All right.
The one that's bleeding.
So it's going to have some cover for this, but go on. You're basically leaning in through the open window to throw a dagger at her as she's bleeding out while trying to put the fire out.
Yeah. Yeah.
Sweet.
Let's see. How about a 27 to hit?
27, oh, yeah. Even with cover hits.
We're going to deal 6 damage.
And it slices right past her cheek, slicing it open right at the jaw, before returning back to your hand. And she's not quite dead, but she's hurting real bad.
How come they're not taking fire damage from the fire that they're stepping on? It's got to be getting hot in there.
They haven't needed to as of yet. which takes us to the fireplace. It's going to use some actions to do fireplace things. Here's the best part. It has an action specifically designed to go against the occupants inside. For three actions, the animated fireplace uses something called Fan the Flames. And in a 30-foot cone, it breathes a gout of flame from its opening maw, getting everybody inside. And they need to make reflex saves.
Yes. It's turning into this thing.
Kill one of your own people.
Who thought it was a good idea to animate a fireplace?
Yeah, the fireplace don't give no fucks. Sweet, they all fail with various rolls of failure and take 7 points of fire damage.
Kind of worried that a 21 fails.
Yeah, 21 fails. 21's the highest roll they got, and that failed. That kills the one fetchling who had already been hurt by Sundrinker and by Gerdrug. And she falls. Gerdrug can see the flames now spreading throughout the entirety of the common room floor. Kix, it's your turn.
Fire! A 15.
Kix fans the flames successfully, now spreading from the bushes to the exterior eastern wall of the common room, beginning to match the heat from inside. That takes us over to one of the folks inside, who now is looking up outside the window at Gerdrug in a rage. Uses his first action to draw his dagger, his second action to use something called Shadow Stride, and he almost disappears from the place he's standing next to the fireplace to right next to you just outside the window, and he's going to strike at you as though he's concealed. And his third action is to strike. This is a 26 hit.
Absolutely.
That should be rolling sneak attack too.
No, it shouldn't, because I got denied advantage.
Oh, that's...
This is higher level.
And you're... What level are you? Three?
Four?
Yeah. Deny advantage triggers here. So yeah, you take 7 points of piercing damage from the dagger through the window, the open window.
Dude thought he was being special. Nope.
He did. Got wrecked by the ghost outside his... the ghost on his porch. The small, fey man who's standing on the table continues to cast spells to attempt to put water out, or fires out with water.
No, my cottage! Not my cottage!
Lucan, it's your turn.
I don't give a shit about this guy's cottage. I'm actively trying to burn it. Lucan will move up, and Sundrinker will move over using tandem movement for one action. I can only see this guy, but I think I can see him well enough to target him with a act together Ray of Frost. Or not Ray of Frost. Electric Arc.
Yes.
Reflex save, please.
Okay. It's concealed. Yeah. What was your check on that?
Yeah, I get a 5, which it does it on the nose.
That's what you need. Yeah. Reflex save. He doesn't do great. 16.
That is a failure. He will take the full damage, which is 9. 9 electric damage.
And as he's extended out through the window, you hit him with an electric arc right in the arm, and it runs up his body and begins to shock him inside.
And then Sundrinker will take their single action from Act Together and will strike him. No idea what this guy... I guess he's a fetchling. I don't really know anything about fetchlings, but slashing seemed to work on the last one, so we'll try that again. Here's the attack.
I mean, you know, flesh is, in fact, flesh.
I miss, though.
13 will miss.
Rolled a 2.
That takes us over to Arius.
Arius continues to stare at this fucking door, just waiting for some dumb motherfucker to come open it. Uses 2 action to ready an action to slash a fucker that opens the door. I don't know.
Alright. Gerdrug, it's your turn.
Yeah, I'm thinking I'm getting kind of tired of this guy. How big is this window?
You'll have to acrobatics to get through it.
Oh, yeah, I totally plan on diving through this window, yes.
Then, yeah, it'll be just be part of your tumble through.
Good, because that's exactly what I wanted to do. 17.
A 17 fails.
Yeah, fuck it. We're hero pointing it. 24.
24 is a success.
Okay, and because I successfully tumbled behind, he is flat-footed to my attack. Can you give him flat-footed? We'll see if he has the same thing I have. I will use the still-drawn dog slicer. Damn it! Ooh. All that work and I miss.
15 will miss.
Well, I opened up flanking for somebody.
Then, after Gurdrug, that takes us over to the animated fireplace. The animated fireplace sees somebody that he hasn't been prevented from attacking and shifts itself from the corner and starts striding over toward Gurdrug, moving chairs and the table out of its way as it does so.
It had been prevented from attacking those other people?
I mean, not beknownst to you, but... Oh, it didn't consider spewing flames attacking them. Like, that was just, I'm consuming, this is the consequence, and you're in my way. Now it's actively going to try to eat somebody. And that somebody is Gurdrug.
Ghost.
Gurdrug does a 28 hit.
I mean, yeah.
Yeah. Take 10 points of damage. Some bludgeoning, some fire.
Why would you eat a ghost? That's just empty calories.
Eh. No. Bad baby.
That's terrible, but... Hey, it worked. I only took 9 damage. I have 2 fire resistance.
It even has a little eye there that says resistant to fire -1.
So I only took 9. Not that that's...
Fuck yeah.
Would have been a lot better if that fire would have been higher and more of it would have been fire. But, you know.
Yeah, it was only 1 fire damage.
So I only take 9.
Then with its third action... It uses grab. So you are now grabbed by the fireplace.
I'm immune to grab. I'm a ghost.
How long are we gonna do that?
Constantly.
Till he's dead.
Constantly.
From now until the end of the campaign.
16 more levels. You better be ready for it.
Kix, it's your turn.
So I've seen that the... Fuck it, I just keep going. I got, there's just a fury in my eyes, and I'm really excited.
Now Kix is just like, burn this fucker to the ground.
More fire.
What'd you get on your d20?
18!
Well, the dice are trying to tell that story, too. You fan the flames to now have, they are up to the eaves along that section of the eastern wall, and it's beginning to set the roof on fire.
Yeah!
Hell yeah.
Alright, then after Kix sets the roof on fire, that's taking us over to the tiefling who just got tumbled through, the only one that's in there. He spins around in the common room, which is just aflame, and looks at Gurdrug with his dagger in hand and says, "How dare you! Do you have any idea what's going to happen to you after you kill me?" And he uses his first action to lunge at you with his dagger. Gets a 30 to hit.
I might have made a tactical mistake, guys.
I may have.
You went in there, brah.
He was excited. He was getting bored.
The critical hit deals you 18 points of damage.
Yes, it does.
And even as he connects with you, he smiles a little bit. But then he... glances at the fire in the room and he says, "This isn't even going to do anything to her, you fool!" And uses another action to strike. 11 to hit?
No.
He uses his third action to attempt to tumble through your square. Gets a 15?
That's against my reflex DC, right?
Correct.
Yeah. No.
Yeah, I figured that was going to be the case. He tries to squeeze past you because the fireplace... is on the other side of him, and while they're not exactly allies, he's not an enemy either. He can't just squeeze through the fireplace's square while he's grabbing onto you. So as he tries to skirt around you as you're getting eaten by the fireplace, you stop him. Just die already! Top of round 7. Feyman continues to put out fires. Lucan, it's your turn.
Well, act together. No, I'm not even going to do act together. Let's see if Sundricker can just kill this guy. Sundricker is going to use my first action to just attack this guy through the window. Strike. Oh my gosh, I cannot roll. Cannot roll. All right. Act together, two actions. Lucan will cast an electric arc. Reflex save.
Okay. You can't see the fireplace, so this is just the...
Yeah, this is just the guy.
He gets 14.
Thank God. He will take all of this damage, which is 10 electric damage.
And he is orating to Gerdrug, who's being eaten by the fireplace inside, and he gets zapped in the middle of it. And he's smoldering, but still standing.
And Sundrinker will take their single action from Act Together with the multiple attack penalty to try and just kill this guy. No, can't do it. Can't roll.
Then that takes us over to Arius. That door, pretty sturdy looking door.
I continue to stare at the door.
Gerdrug. Hold on. Can I, real quick, I'm going to give Ted a hero point specifically for sticking to this one thing that he decides he's going to hang on to. And we're 7 rounds into combat and he's waiting for that fucking door to open. And for some reason that fits Arius and I'll count it as role playing. Take a hero point. Ted, how often do you just, like, completely sacrifice entire turns because you don't know what to do? Like, the wizard, sure, a couple of actions here and there, but entire turns?
I mean, I'm not going in the fucking building. I don't know what else.
Crazy.
There's war going on in the building.
Yeah, I don't know if I'd call that war. It's just kind of Gerdrug getting his ass kicked, isn't it?
Come on, one-on-one, this guy's already almost dead.
We made a plan to burn down the building, and you decided to jump through the window into the building?
Well, I had to stop the guy from putting the fire out.
Yeah, well, we could just start more fires.
Teamwork!
I don't know.
Oh, my God. Well, Gerdrug, it's your turn.
Oh, I'm stabbing this dude. Apparently, I'm not.
First action misses, 16 doesn't hit.
Game just can't let me have anything fun.
Nope, just being eaten by a fireplace and a bunch of missed stabs.
I'm just gonna stab this guy again.
Stab, stab.
I guess we'll do the. I have to do my escape action first. I have to try to escape this dude. Because that's a multiple attack penalty, isn't it?
It is, yeah.
22.
A 22?
Probably gonna fail.
It's just a fireplace, dude.
But it's a really big fireplace.
It's a pretty big fucking fireplace.
Easier to fit through the grates. His teeth.
A 22 is a success.
Okay. Yeah, I'm jumping back through that window.
You gonna tumble through, get through it again?
Yeah.
Get the fuck out of here.
Sorry, guys. Sorry about that.
Give me your acrobatics.
Oh, God. Roll another 4. That's what I rolled up my first one last time. I fail.
A 15 will fail.
Yep, my movement is stopped.
Gerdrug stuck.
Failed to get out, and now I die.
And it's the fireplace's turn. And the fireplace is gonna use his first action to attack. Get a 33 to hit.
Yeah, that's a critical.
Deal Gerdrug 20 points of damage, 2 of it fire.
Well, joke's on you. I only take 14.
Conscious. Oh, I see, because you went to 0. Got it.
And it's a critical hit. Fuck, that means I'm dying too.
It uses a second action to grab Gerdrug's unconscious form.
Not actually on fire, am I? He's just going to eat me.
It uses its third action to swallow Gerdrug whole.
At level 4?
It does have to make a check for swallow hole.
Oh, like it's gonna fail.
Yeah, I know.
God damn it, Swanee. Now we all gotta go in the fucking fired house.
No, now I need to figure out how to introduce my new character. Because I'm dead. There's no way you guys can save me.
It gets 27 to swallow Gerdrug hole.
You're a ghost. You don't need to breathe.
That's its turn.
I'm unconscious. I can't hold my breath or anything.
Oh, I didn't realize you were unconscious.
Kix, it's your turn.
Anyways, am I Is Sundrinker gonna make me aware? Is anyone making me aware of anything right now?
Sundrinker can see the situation.
Yes. Sundrinker has a free action.
I do believe they've just killed Gurdrug. The fireplace ate him.
Wasn't Gurdrug already dead? He was a ghost.
I was actually going to wait for his turn, but I might as well just do it now. The fetchling is a free action. As the fireplace is eating Gurdrug, it's like, you didn't even get the chance to kill me before you were destroyed. Who's next?
So yeah, unconscious. So when I run out of air, you fall unconscious. So being unconscious would just start the suffocating rules immediately.
It would. And how much time do you have under suffocation?
Can't recover from being unconscious and must attempt a DC 20 fortitude save at the end of your turn. On a failure, you take 1d10 damage. On a critical failure, you die. On each check after the first, the DC increases by 5 and the damage by 1d10.
Okay, so damage doesn't really matter a ton because you taking damage while under is enough as is. But this so could technically come out with you on top. So, which one happens first? Your recovery check or the suffocation check?
So he swallowed me, right?
Mm-hmm.
That did me more damage, correct?
That's a good point, actually. Yes, he would deal you an additional 15 points of fire damage, yeah.
I'm just going to dying 3.
So you're dying 3 now. Okay. So which happens first? The suffocation roll or the recovery check? Because Gurdrug literally hinges on that right now.
They're just both at the end of each turn.
I thought the recovery check was at the beginning.
Oh, it started at your turn. You get the recovery check at the start of your turn.
So recovery happens first, so there is a chance for you to recover enough to take the damage that you're going to take from suffocation. Okay.
Possibly, yes.
Possibly. It's a maybe at this point.
I was not expecting the fireplace to actually fucking move.
Yeah. Kix, it's your turn.
Well, I'll move forward. I mean, I move back up to the stairwell.
Now you got the roof on fire.
Can I see that guy? I can see, like, it looks like I see a portrait. Can I see him?
Yeah, you have sight to him. He'll have covered anything that you make with that has the attack trait. But you do have line of effect to him, yes.
But I can't see Gurdrug because he's inside of a fire pit.
Correct.
Swallowed whole is the word.
Yeah.
Or phrase.
Did we break that window or did we just open it?
It's just open.
Yeah, Gurdrug opened it at the start.
Well, I'll just wait to move up again because otherwise I won't be able to do anything. So I'll just target that guy and attempt to make an attack. 27 to hit.
27 hits him through cover.
I threw a rock at him.
Hell yeah.
And as he's laughing at Gurdrug dying before he even gets a chance to kill him, rock comes in through the window. Hits him in the head. Kills him outright.
That was the water guy or no? No, that's not the old guy. That's the...
No, that was the final fetchling. There were two fetchlings in the common room. They are now both dead. And Gurdrug is inside of a fireplace.
That's all I got.
That takes us to the top of round 8. Sundrinker would be able to hear from inside.
Good, now that the idiots are dead, get back into place and help me put this thing out!
And you hear the fireplace rumble in response.
No, you dummy! This is where we live! Put it out!
And it continues to cast water spells at the fire that is spreading inside. Lucan, it's your turn.
I have no idea what to do to try and save Gurdrug.
Tell Arius what to do to save Gurdrug.
Don't you just need an AoE? Does Harm have a line of sight?
That's what I'm thinking. I don't know if
an AoE harm goes through walls, though, does it? Have we ruled that?
Probably not walls, but would it go through the monster?
When creating an effect, you usually need an unblocked path to the target of a spell, the origin point of an effect's area, or the place where you create something with a spell or other ability. You have line of effect unless a creature is entirely behind a solid physical barrier. Visibility doesn't matter for line of effect, nor do portcullises or other barriers that aren't totally solid. If you're unsure whether a barrier is solid enough, a 10-foot square gap is enough to maintain line of effect. In an area effect, creatures or targets must have line of effect to the point of origin to be affected. If there's no line of effect between the origin of the area and the target, the effect doesn't apply to that target.
So my harm wave won't go out through the window and then back in? Is what I'm getting?
No. Yeah. That's the correct answer.
Arius, I think the time to act might be now, says Lucan.
I think Gerdrug's fucked.
Basically, the door is in your way, and then Gerdrug being inside of the fireplace is in your way. You have those two barriers to overcome.
Unless you can get Gerdrug out of the fireplace for me to heal him.
I don't know. Sundrinker will use tandem movement, and Sundrinker is going to try and make their way through the window. What do I need to do that?
If you want to make it through the window and have movement afterwards, it would be tumble through. Just making it through the window is a single action.
Okay, so we'll try and do a tumble through. Acrobatics from the Sundrinker. And we'll get a 24.
That is a success. So you'll get movement after the tumble.
And then also with tandem movement, Lucan will move to the window, kind of the corner of the patio, so I can see in through the window.
Okay.
I see the fireplace, and I see the little guy. And two actions act together. Electric arc on the little guy and the fireplace. We're going to give this a shot. Little boy. Reflex saves, please.
Okay, and this is for the little guy and the fireplace. All right.
Yep.
The fireplace gets a 15, and the little guy gets a 15 as well.
They both fail. They'll both take this full damage, which is going to be seven electric damage. Then, as a single action, Sundrinker will use Thundering Roar as a single action. Each enemy in a 10-foot emanation takes 48 sonic damage with a basic will save. So I need a basic will save from both the little guy and the fireplace.
That was that setup at the beginning. Will save, you said?
Yeah. Will save.
The little guy gets a nat 20. Fireplace gets a 17.
Little guy critically succeeds. Fireplace fails.
That's the one that matters anyway.
So that's 48 damage. Fireplace will take all of it. That will be 20 sonic damage.
20 sonic damage. Let me double check.
To the fireplace.
Yep, all that damage goes through.
Perfect. All right, that is my turn.
Arius, it's your turn.
I think it's too late for me to act. I don't know what I can even do at this point. I'm in front of a locked door. You're blocking the window, so I can't go through there.
You could attempt to break the door down.
So I'd have to break the door down.
Correct.
I will attempt to break the door down. What's that going to take? Athletics?
Yes. Force open is what this is.
Oh, come on. That was so close to being a 19. 18 total.
And the 18 is a failure.
A hero point. 23.
Almost a 20.
A 23 is a success. So you would break the door open for you to be able to get through it.
There's a giant fireplace.
Do I, though? I don't think force open works like that.
Yeah, dude. Success on force open. You break the door, window, or container, or gate open, and the door, window, container, or gate gains the broken condition.
Okay.
If especially sturdy, I might have it take damage and not be broken, but this is not an especially sturdy front door.
It's a fucking window, or wooden door. Okay, perfect. Bust open that door. Shit, is that attack trait? Yeah, it does. Gross.
Yes.
And Gerdrug's inside of it, so I can't target him for a heal.
Because of the way that line of effect works, that's correct. Your best bet would be to kill the fireplace and physically extract Gerdrug in two actions.
Because, we did rule when we were fighting those plant creatures that the guy that was swallowed whole didn't get hurt by our AoEs either.
Yeah.
But we are being consistent.
Which was why you didn't get harmed by the Thundering Roar.
Thundering Roar only targets 70s.
No, well, anyways.
All right. Target him and take a swing. 16.
16 misses.
Hero point.
I did give you a second, didn't I?
You did.
He was hoping for that nat 20. You are getting flank in here.
15 to hit. Third action, I'll take another swing. So close to being a nat 20. 14 to hit.
Bust that door open, but miss on the swings. And that takes us over to Gerdrug. Swanee, how's this going to go?
So I get a recovery check. Dying has a value. If you reach 4, you die. If you're dying, you must attempt a recovery check at the start of your turn each round to determine whether you're dying. It increases by 1.
So at this moment, Gerdrug is dying 3.
Dying 3. So my DC is 13.
So you had to roll a d20, get
this
a 13.
Is a straight up 1d20 roll.
Do you still have your hero point or no?
No. Fuck, it's a 12. A fucking 12. Failure, your dying value increases by 1.
What about that hero point Tyler gave you for being awesome and going through the window?
What?
He was doing such rogue things. Don't you remember giving him that hero point since we've been playing for 3 hours? And
it won't even matter.
Because he's just going to kill him anyways.
It's, well, I feel like this is just, like, this is what the dice want to say,
well,
right now.
I was going
to
say use the hero point to stabilize.
It still wouldn't matter.
Wouldn't that take you to wounded one?
At the end of my turn, I would still suffocate and die, probably.
Oh, that's true.
Yeah, suffocation would make you go right back and dying, if not even considering the swallowed hole damage, the fire damage from just being in the thing.
Yeah, and I don't think I want to, I mean, retconning a hero point from that long ago.
I mean, David could just cut it in.
Just cut it in.
Gerdrug's form inside of the animated fireplace burns the last ectoplasmic vestiges of Gerdrug's life force, and as Gerdrug's life force finally dissipates from this world, he gets one last little flashback as a hobgoblin strapped down to the torture table of a Kuthite, an Imbrex, a line that Gerdrug had cursed with the last dying breaths that he had as this man stood over him and cut little bits of his life out. More than 30 years ago. All that hate, all that suffering disappears into the River Styx and is gone.
I fucked up, guys.
You sure did.
Gerdrug's dead.
Did not expect that fireplace to move.
I did also did not expect the fireplace to move.
I expected we were setting the place on fire, so I don't know why you'd go outside, but...
Yeah, that was Spencer.
Because the guy was going to put it out.
That's why I was starting on the outside.
And we just start more fires. Yeah.
He's got water spells. He could have stopped it. It's like a wet paper bag. It can keep the whole thing from going out.
To make Swanee feel better about this, he's actually right. If you wouldn't have stopped the dude inside from putting out the fires, your plan wouldn't have worked no matter how much you did on the outside.
He's tired. He's got to sleep eventually.
I think you'd underestimate how persistent
I will
Spencer
fucking
is.
Burn.
I mean, because it's like a paper bag. If you can keep the inside wet, the outside isn't going to burn.
I already started the fucking house on fire. The more fire he puts out, the more fire there's the more smoke is gonna be. There should have been. I'm looking up smoking. You should all be fucking suffocating in there.
Well, I opened the door.
Okay,
so
open the door in a fucking house on fire.
Opens.
It doesn't just clear it out.
A cross breeze coming through.
That's very true. That's back, very
back
true.
Draft. You should have had a backdraft. You should have had
round,
a backdraft.
Round 8. This fire has had less than 1 minute to properly stoke. Yes, it's got a bunch of influence from inside, and they have taken proper sickened conditions from that. Rest in peace, Gerdrug. Swanee.
Yeah, you guys finish this, and then we'll have to have a conversation about what character I should bring in.
In the meantime, it is the animated fireplace's turn. And now that it's devoured one essence, it wants another. It turns to Sundrinker and uses its first action to attack.
Nah, he doesn't like salad.
Gets a 25 to hit.
That will hit.
Take 19 points of damage, 5 of that being fire.
19 damage, my goodness.
It uses its second action to grab Sundrinker. And now that we're here and we all know the name of the game, it uses its third action to swallow whole.
Okay.
Only gets a 16 on the swallow whole, though.
Against what?
Man, I'm going to write a strongly written email to Paizo about swallow whole being bullshit.
Against your reflex DC.
Oh, that will fail.
That will fail. Okay, so the swallow hole doesn't go off, but they are grabbed.
All right.
That's the fireplace's turn. That takes us over to Kix. It's your turn.
Kix, the door is open. You can see the fireplace.
The fireplace is there?
Yeah, I had no fucking clue it was there either. I thought it was going to open into like a hallway.
Not just cave.
No, it's been walking around.
No, it fucking moved up to me.
I didn't realize this was one room either.
He ran across the fucking living room to get there.
For some reason, I was imagining there was like a hallway here and like they were in a different room. So when I opened the door and the fireplace was there, I was like, what the fuck?
It's literally in your face as you open the front door.
Yes, yeah, I was not expecting that.
Hey, so I remember when you said he's going to have 16 more levels of you making jokes about ghost things?
I'm making a new ghost. Fuck you. No, I'm not actually. I don't think any of my backup characters were ghosts.
Unleash Psyche!
I have like 6 made. I've decided.
Telekinetics.
Really?
Well, I mean, we gotta figure out which one would be able to join from the Axenwood. But yeah, you just said.
Make a character, you make it fucking work. Nah, you can't play that guy because he wouldn't be in a woods.
We'll make it work. Obviously, we'll make it work.
Just do some fucking skeleton, and I'll just go dig you up out of the ground in the backyard.
So that's one of my two preferred options, is actually a skeletal monk.
Skeletal monk?
Yeah.
That's pretty fucking cool.
Monstrous skeletal monk. So like a minotaur-like skeletal monk or something?
Fuck yeah.
25 to hit.
25 hits the animated fireplace.
With like another rock. And that's plus 4 for 15.
For 15, it takes all of that damage.
And then I need a reflex save.
It's not very good at these. 9.
That was a side burst for one action. Oh, I can't side burst him, probably.
Side burst.
Wait, concentrate, evocation, mind shift, occult, psyche, psychic. It doesn't actually say it.
This is basics reflex.
I know, but I'm just wondering. It doesn't say anything about
it. It doesn't have mental. It wouldn't work if it had the mental trait. Unless there's something in mind shift that would indicate that that is also the mental trait, but...
An action with this trait can always be altered to use the raw power of your mind. When you take this action, you can choose to replace any damage it deals with mental damage. Give it the mental trait and replace any save it requires of a will save.
You can choose.
This can be a reflex save or a will save, whatever I deem.
Yeah, you can actually, because it has the mind shift trait, you can choose to make it a will save. And that also makes it mental. But if you choose to keep it as will, or sorry, reflex, it doesn't have the mental trait.
Well, 6 damage.
All right.
That's all I got.
What type of damage is that? Oh, bludgeoning? Well, yeah.
I assume mind shift would probably make it.
Just the raw power of his mind bludgeons the fireplace.
That is exactly what we're going for, apparently. All right, well, that takes us to the top of round 9. I've been keeping the Fae kind of out of the combat here by having it cast spells, and it's going to continue to do that, but it's going to reposition itself. It's going to jump down from off of the table, down onto the floor, and begin to try to put out the fire that's in the space in the corner of the hut here. And that takes us over to Lucan.
All right, so he is within 30 feet. I will do two actions act together, and Lucan will electric arc both the caster and the fireplace. Reflex saves, please.
All right. Let's see. The caster gets a 28.
That's a success.
Fireplace gets a 15.
That's a failure. So the caster will take half. The fireplace will take full of 9 damage. And then with their single action from act together, Sundrinker will attack the fireplace. Bludgeoning, I suppose. Bludgeoning seems like the right way to go. And we'll get a 22 to hit.
A 22 hits.
And we'll deal 13 bludgeoning damage.
After the electric arc loosens up some of the mortar that was holding the now, after getting beat up, loosely put together bricks of the fireplace, Sundrinker comes down with a big bludgeoning vine and smashes it, and fire and coals and embers spray through the room. You can clearly see that you have smashed this thing to bits, and as Sundrinker and Lucan are staring at that spot looking for Gerdrug's form, you do not see it.
Alright. Well, then, with my final action, Sundrinker moves to the south of Little Magic Man. And that is my turn.
Okay. Arius, you're staring into the common room here. Fireplace is destroyed. The fire is still, you know, on its guttering because of these gouts of water that this guy is spraying onto them. It's not quite out, but it's not spreading very well right now.
Arius uses his first action to move into the room and get into flanking on the remaining enemy with Sundrinker. Second action will take a swing and gets a 14 to hit.
And they'll miss.
Okay. Third action, I'll take another swing and get another 14. Just fucking move on.
Yeah, that'll miss too. Swing, swing.
Hey, at least you've got an attack of opportunity.
That yes, takes us over to Kit.
Assuming I roll better magically. I rolled so well that at the start of it tonight, and now like combat starts, that's like it all goes to shit.
Where is this thing?
It's a small thing between us.
I step in and throw some more stuff. Oof. Hero point. 21 to hit.
There you go.
21 hits.
17 damage.
Ooh. 17?
Yeah, I have psychic and I'm unleashed.
Nice.
17 is exactly what you needed to put this guy down.
I wanted to start the fucking house on fire! Fucking ruin everything.
Now we start burning shit and then we get out.
Oh yeah, this place is going down.
Yeah, it's like Sundrinker on fire.
No!
We're gonna go out of encounter mode because no immediate threats aside from the fire are present. So it really depends on what everybody does with their actions. Do you flee the house now that all of the moving opposition is no longer moving?
I mean, we start more fires and then leave.
We start more fires and leave. Exactly.
Can we do a quick rundown of the place?
And we loot Gerdrug's corpse for any plot relevant or campaign relevant items he might have had on him.
So is the fire done inside?
No, not. I mean, if you stoke it from here, it will continue to burn. If you don't stoke it from here, it's likely going to gutter out.
All right, well, then who cares? Yeah, let's go search this place then.
I spent a couple rounds stoking the fire.
You don't want to search the house?
What?
Like, we still want to stoke. Like, if it's not,
yeah, we can search the house quick before we stoke the fire.
All right, fine.
Gerdrug didn't have any plot relevant items on him, right? Like key items?
No.
Okay.
I'm not going into any of these other rooms, though.
I crack open the other doors. Hello, is anybody else here? We're burning the place down.
Yeah.
Everyone
so,
get out!
Because...
Hurry up!
Evacuate. Burning it down.
Beep, 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 beep. Wait, is that smoke alarm? Is that no? That's like car backing up.
Well, so we're down a man now. Shall we continue, do you think, or wait?
Well, we got a job to do.
Yes, I've expended most of my second level spells, and we, again, just had one of our compatriots die.
Oh, we're fine. We didn't.
They were already dead.
Yes. But all right, then, if we feel we can continue just the three of us.
Yeah, we'll just throw kicks through every door.
I mean, I don't hate the idea. Sorry, kicks, hello. Just kidding, darling. I search around in the area.
All right.
Being very careful of fucking fireplaces if there are any more of them.
I do the same.
Is that a stove down there in the lower right-hand corner? I stay the fuck away from that.
Better watch the fuck out for that stove.
And so the tortured spirit that was Gerdrug is tortured no longer. At least as far as we know. And if Gerdrug was your favorite character and you'd like to see him return, write us a letter at 123, well, too bad I guess Lane, and we'll be sure to take your advice on board. The real question now is, if we struggled that much with Iron Tavia's fireplace, how on earth are we going to defeat her and the rest of her cottage? Gee, I sure hope a random new guy shows up to help us in that endeavor. I guess find out next time as we continue Bloodlords. And until then, may you have many great adventures of your own.
It's your turn.
But not Gerdrug's, because he's dead.